How this Malaysian Marathon League works is basically it's a 42 kilometer challenge. We break it into two categories. You either run in the category of male or female. Yeah, although it's 42 kilometer, but we don't we stretch it over a few runs, which I will explain in a while, right? So any participant, you have to choose the states that you want to represent. Right now, there is 13 states plus one federal territory, right? So if you want to run for Labuan, if you want to run for Labuan, Putrajaya, or Kuala Lumpur, right? You can say that you want to represent that team, but when you submit a result, you are submitting your result to the federal territory results or leaderboard. Yeah. So usually people will choose the state that they are born or the state that they are domiciling in. Yeah. So you want to choose a category. Right now we are at a stage where we are opening up for just registration. Yeah. Race haven't started. From 1st to 4th of April, we will open the registration. A lot of states runners are coming in. I can tell you, it is very hot in Sarawak. It is very hot in Penang. You can see from our community discussion, right? The number of people who say which state they are representing, you can see, right? And there are a lot of actually elite runners inside here, right? So everybody is trying to make their state the first national champion.
Okay. Even though I was born in Penang, I spent most of my time in Melaka, and my running actually started in Melaka. So Melaka has a good impact to my running journey actually. So definitely I will make sure that our Melaka people, Alu Gajah, apa, Air Keruh, will come together and beat Penang, nothing else.
You have to think of your asal usul, yeah, right? Your roots, right? It's important. You go to Penang.
It's already registered under Melaka, so definitely Melaka will win.